nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. Pull up on a minute, look nice, look nice. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. Yeah, we look nice, future looking nice, we don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Yeah, we look nice, future looking real nice, we don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
This time last season, Adelaide inflicted Brisbane's biggest defeat in the Liberty A-League with an 8-2 destruction. Fiona Wirtz scored 5 and the Reds were flying towards their first finals appearance. But less than 12 months on, and Adelaide are looking for answers after 3 consecutive defeats and almost 6 hours without a goal. And the reigning Julie Dolan medalist, Fiona Wirtz, hasn't scored. Today, Brisbane get their shot at redemption. With Adelaide struggling, can the Roar inflict a painful defeat, which could prove destructive to the Reds' finals ambitions? This is the team that Gareth McPherson hopes to get the 3 points with. 4 changes from the Roar's 4-1 humbling to Sydney on New Year's Eve. New signing India Paige Riley is straight into the starting 11 after signing for the club this week from Fortuna Høring in Denmark. She replaces Sian Fryer. Another big inclusion is American keeper Hensley Handcuff, who's back from a back complaint, replacing Isabella Shuttleworth. And fullbacks Jesse Rashart and Talitha Kramer will start for the Roar in place of Tamar Levin and Tegan Thompson. It's Adelaide's 3rd match in a week, but just the 1 change for Adrian Stenter's side. The Reds coach is hoping a reshuffle up top is enough to address their goal-scoring woes. Teenager Amelia Murray slots in up front, pushing Fiona Wirtz to the left wing and Paige Haywood to left back. That means Emily Hodgson is the player missing out. She drops to the bench for this clash. Brisbane Roar will be hoping for 3 points, but Gareth McPherson, he'll be hoping for a win and an extra special celebration for his 40th birthday. It would take the Roar to within goal difference of the top 4 with those 3 vital points today. Sydney sider Beck Mackey in charge of her 18th A-League women's match. She's assisted today by Maggie Price and Avril Beecham. Rachel Mitchinson is the 4th official. Speaking of the top 4, a win for Adelaide would push them back into the top 4. That's how tight it is around that middle part of the table. And that would be the perfect tonic for Adrian Stenter's side. He's never lost 3 straight matches in the Liberty A-League leading into this season. Well, that's where they sit right now. He was the coach of the year last year. He said they're not worried about where they sit on the table right now. He just wants the Reds to play well and end this losing run. And preferably grab a goal, because they haven't scored in almost 6 hours of football in the Liberty A-League. Well, their job will be all the more difficult going up against India Paige Riley, the New Zealand international, switched Høring in Denmark for Brisbane in a big game, of course, to get some game time for the World Cup, which is coming up later this year. Across her time in Denmark, she played in the UEFA Women's Champions League back in 2021 against Barcelona. That was the same year Amelia Murray debuted in the A-League Women. Now she's looking to make a name for herself. Already with 1 goal this season, she has come off the back of 12-12 in the MPLW South Australia. Could she be the player to end the Reds' goal drought today, which, as I said, has stretched to almost 6 hours? The last goal was an own goal they scored against Wellington last month. Great crowd in at AJ Kelly Park this afternoon. And Brisbane, they have a good record against the Reds in the Sunshine State. 8-4 they lead the head-to-heads with the 1 draw overall. have been quite dominant against Adelaide down the years, which is no surprises because up until probably the last few seasons, Brisbane has been quite the dominant force when it comes to the back end of the season and the finals in the Liberty A-League. They lead the overall head-to-head 13-5. So Brisbane look to close the gap on the top four as the Reds aim to snap a three-match losing streak in Queensland this afternoon. An intriguing contest on the way with the ladder really long jammed around the middle part, and we know this is the halfway point of the season. 10 of 20 rounds for Adelaide. This is their ninth match, so they do reach the halfway point. Brisbane still have a match in hand, but they won't want to let points drop here. It would be back-to-back defeats for the Roar for the second time this season. As Lind finding Rashard, it was well closed down there by Paige Haywood, who's dropped into that left fullback role today. Emily Hodgson back to the bench with Fiona Wirt slotting in on the left wing with Amelia Murray playing in the center. Katrina Gorry finding Palmer, and now Rashard. Flip forward into some space by Lind. Adelaide defense though reading it well, and now trying to spring forward through Wirtz. Just incredible to think that last season's Golden Boot, Julie Dolan medal winner, yet to grab a goal this season in the six matches she's played. Just five goals for the Reds in eight A-League women's matches so far this campaign. In stark contrast to the 33 goals they scored across the 14 regular season matches last year. So averaging just over two a game. Of course, eight came in the most recent match between these two sides in that 8-2 win. And Shea Connors just finds Gorry. Could open up here nicely. What a pass that is from Gorry just to find Palmer. Adelaide able to cut it out though. Larissa Crummer did well enough, and Gorry finding Shea Connors. Seven goals last season, yet to score this campaign, and great strike on goal and finished off for Brisbane Roar, but the flag has come up to deny the new recruit. Well, what a start that would have been back in the Brisbane Roar orange for India Paige Riley. Shea Connors taking on Hodgson, and India Paige Riley deemed to be offside when that strike on goal was hit, giving her an unfair advantage. Of course, India Paige Riley played the one match for the Matildas and then switched allegiance to New Zealand. She's now got five caps and looking to be a part of that squad for the home World Cup. Wirtz just out-muscled. Some strong work at the back from Brisbane, but Dylan Holmes just fed in behind, delivering across in front of Amelia Murray. So pretty open start to this match. Some chances at both ends. Gorry searching for Crummer. But Anna Lee Grove coming out to claim. Now this is the disallowed goal. So you can see India Paige Riley as the strike is taken pretty clearly beyond the final defender, giving her an unfair advantage to put that one into the back of the net. But she is going to be so crucial for Brisbane Roar. Amelia Murray in behind to try and end this goal drought for the Reds. And it flashes across the face. And she'll be disappointed she didn't at least force a save from Hensley Handcuff, who's returning from a back complaint. Maybe looking for the cross there to Fiona Wirtz, just overhit it, as you could just see in her eye line, was looking for the English import. So Nano Sasaka, who slotted into that centre back role pretty nicely for Adelaide. With the injuries they've got in that part of the pitch, Fiona Wirtz taking on a couple. Adelaide looking really dangerous inside the opening 6 minutes of this one. And in hot conditions in Queensland, both sides playing at a very high pace. Up in the high 20s today. Humidity not too high, around the 48% mark. And now Dylan Holmes charging after a ball over the top, but Handcuff out to claim. And you sense that the goalkeeper is someone that Adelaide might want to test out after she just was left out of that match against Sydney FC a couple of weeks ago as a precaution. Isabella Shuttleworth, the goalkeeper who took her place, is missing from the match day squad today because she's just picked up a little niggle. As Amelia Murray with a deflection, Handcuff slipped over. She would have had a heart in her mouth for a moment. It's going to be a corner for Adelaide United. And the 18-year-old has looked really bright to start this match. Played a junior football in Albury Wodonga. He's got some great pedigree. Her dad and her uncle played in the AFL. So really talented athlete. And has already scored once this season. Looking to get on the end of this Fiona Wirtz corner. And it's really towards the near post. Set up for Holmes. But the angle was shut down by the Roar. And now they look to break through India Paige Riley. Beck Mackey is going to come back for the free kick, much to the frustration of Dylan Holmes. And to be fair, I think she's got a point. It looked as though there wasn't much pressure from Isabel Hodgson. And down went India Paige Riley and probably got a cheap free kick there. There's Gorry trying to turn Westland around, and now she's given away a free kick for reaching over the back. And now it's Brisbane's turn to ask the question of Beck Mackey. Well, it didn't look like much going on there, but at least the referee is consistent. Sasaki driving the ball forward. Good signs continuing here for Adelaide United as Westland dropping it back towards Dorber. And Gorry again looks forward. Wants Crummer to charge after this. Annalie Grove finds the sideline. Did spend some time with Brisbane Roar to Danny Grove. Came up through the Emerging Jets Academy, also spent some time with Canberra United as well, but has found a home with Adelaide United. Didn't play any A-League women's matches with Brisbane or Canberra or Newcastle for that fact. Just over the 10 minutes gone here in Brisbane at AJ Kelly Park. The Roar looking to bounce back from that 4-1 defeat to Sydney here a couple of weeks ago. Their first match of 2023. The Reds playing their third match in a week, and they've earned themselves a corner here. There was a question asked of Adrian Stenter in the pre-match press conference was, is that beneficial that the Reds have had a few games, because they did lose some momentum after that 1-0 win against Wellington. They had a bit of a break there. So they've had consistent game time. If they're not too fatigued, they've certainly got the fitness under their belt as this corner is floated in. Falls for Westland. And have we got a head issue here? Maybe Lind, who is wheeling away. So Beck Mackey saying we're going to have a drop ball. Lynn was wondering why it wasn't a free kick. And that's what happened after the initial incident in the box. There were bodies flying everywhere, so unsurprising that there was a head clash or potential for that. Anyway, play goes on for the Reds. Now the ball in, searching for Murray. Waldus, the Dutch defender. And Dylan Holmes skirting the touchline. Lynn looks to have recovered from the knock a moment ago. And Gorey taking on Barbieri. And she just tries to deliver, but too close to Grove, whose touch almost took it towards Shay Connors. And she'd love a gift to grab her first goal of the season in the Liberty A-League. 8 goals across her career, 7 came last season. But the American yet to get going in this season. 15 of the A-League women's. Barbieri says, let's just get it down the other end of the park. Aisha Nori, the captain's armband, finding Rashard, who's back in the side this week after missing the New Year's Eve clash against Sydney with illness. Riley. Thought she'd started this stint of her career with a goal. Back in the Liberty A-League after a couple of seasons abroad with Fortuna Høring in Denmark. long throw, looking for the target of Crummer. Gorrie trying to cut back the ball in the shadows of the byline, couldn't do so amid the pressure. Very even start to this match day 10 clash in the Liberty A-League. 15 minutes just upon us, and possession is pretty much deadlocked at this stage. Both sides creating some half chances. Brisbane a goal disallowed to India Page Riley for offside. Julie Dolan medalist from last year, Fiona Wirtz, looking for answers this year. Looking to provide, maybe playing on that left flank. Finding Holmes, Beck Mackey gets in the way. Blocks probably a half decent cross there from Dylan Holmes. And Dylan Holmes expressing her frustration again. Referee in the wrong spot. It's a good pick off for the Reds, and Chelsea Dorver, who's driving. Real aimless shot from the Reds' all-time leading goal scorer. Has got the captain's armband today off the back of her 50th appearance on Wednesday night against Melbourne City. Unfortunately for her, not a happy one in that 3-0 defeat. Two goals this season is the Reds' leading goal scorer, but it's slim pickings. She's got two. Dylan Holmes one, Amelia Murray one. Stark contrast to last season, as we said, where they had the golden boot winner. Holly Palmer finding Rashard. Crummer has done well just to hold off Waldis and pull her out of the box. Couldn't find the ball inside though. Rashard again looking for the target of Crummer. And they've done well enough, Adelaide, to earn themselves a goal kick. Defensively, they've been pretty good this season. Fifth best defence, it was even better than that heading into that Melbourne City clash. But they have conceded 7 goals in their last 3, so it's been a sore point for them after 4 of their first 5 matches ended in 1-0 wins to the Reds. And Beck Mackey's going to come back for a free kick for the visitors. Isabel Hodgson just trying to shake this one off. Set piece specialist, maybe not from that kind of range. Nano Sasaki, not her best ever, just drove it to Holly Palmer. She'll get another opportunity here to clip it up the line. Hodgson just brushing off the hair harmlessly to handcuff. So The energy just somewhat gone out of this game in the last 5-10 minutes or so, which is no surprises because the temperature is in the high 20s. And the first 10 minutes was frantic. Both sides going at it. But at the 20-minute mark, no goals to show for it. Talitha Kramer, good to see her back out on the pitch. Came off the bench against Sydney after recovering from keyhole surgery on her knee. Former Western Sydney Wanderer and also Wellington Phoenix fullback. She was at the Knicks last season. Such a crucial, experienced cog in what was a young side in their first season in the competition. And now providing her experience in Brisbane after a season with Capalaba in the NPLW competition. Lind looking for the flick on from Crummer. Hodgson, and now Dorber. Turning it to Westland, returning it to the captain for today, Chelsea Dorber. That's a good win from Dylan Holmes, who strides forward, trying to slip in Amelia Murray. Well cut out by Jamila Rankin, who's lost it. Saying it came out off Dylan Holmes, but it's going to be Adelaide possession. And it did look to go off Rankin over the sideline last. Hodgson to Dorber, and Hodgson's ball back in, easily dealt with by Brisbane. Haywood getting up down the left, and Rashad comfortably back to handcuff. Clearance probably not her best. It just lands in the middle of the park for Adelaide, but Brisbane win it back. Just that desperation from the Roar. And you can see it on show there from India Paige Riley. First match back in the orange since 2020. And Dylan Holmes just going to have to come back and flag up for offside. The birthday boy, Gareth McPherson, watching on, the Brisbane Roar coach. Right in front of that. He had the arm up as Dylan Holmes was called offside. Poked over the top here into the path of Shea Connors, up against the opposite number, Sasaki. Here's the offside call against Dylan Holmes. Hard to tell from that angle, but did look as though she was. Well, that is almost a mistake from Marushka Waldus. And India Paige Riley, well, they've pounced Brisbane. But again, this is the issue both sides are having today. Just in that final third, finding passes, being more clinical. And you can see why in the last few matches, they've just found life a bit difficult. Brisbane a 4-1 defeat to Sydney on New Year's Eve. Added to that, they haven't played in a couple of weeks, so just trying to find their feet again. in competitive mode. Talitha Kramer versus Dorba. She's done well. The experience fullback delivering. Grove couldn't get a hand to it. It falls for India Paige Riley. Well, what a return. Her first match back in the orange of Brisbane. And it's a goal for the new signing, the Kiwi international. She was denied earlier in the match, not this time. All thanks to the good work of Talitha Kramer. Grove was flapping, Riley was driving. She's looked the best player on the pitch in the opening 20 minutes or so, and she deserves that goal. 3 weeks back from Denmark, signing as an injury replacement for Marielle Hecker. What a goal that is for her confidence and for Brisbane Roar in this first half. And Adelaide concede again. 8 unanswered goals now in the Liberty A-League. Into the naughty corner, the goal scorer giving away the free kick. And Mindy Barbieri. Can they find something from a set piece that they can hang their hat on? Adelaide floated in deep. Brisbane do enough. A high boot from Wirtz. And when it's not your season. Those kind of things go against you. Here's the header away from Jamila Rankin. Good powerful header. And then, well, on Katrina Gorry. Earns the free kick. Rasha nodding it into the path of Crummer. Big period of the game here. Brisbane, with the confidence flowing, have a corner. Well, here we go. Crummer and Haywood just coming together. As we see, India Paige Riley, here's the goal. Grove was just all at sea there. Got back into position and then couldn't get a hand on it. She's been so good this season. Hasn't been at her best in the last few matches. But a great strike from India Paige Riley into the top of the goal. Rankin is clipping this straight into the arms of Annalie Grove. And Crummer and Paige Haywood, this is the little coming together here. Ball goes over the sideline. Maybe a little bit of chest on chest, not too much more than that. Katrina Gorry, we know how well she can pick a pass. Bounce up a little awkwardly for Hodgson. Remembering Brisbane trying to bounce back from that 8-2 humiliation from their perspective last season. Against Adelaide United, that was in February last year. Adelaide were free scoring and they were flying up the ladder to earn their spot in the finals for the first time. And less than 12 months on, now they're really finding things difficult as Lind into the book, first player. Today, the Brisbane centre half. Go, Dad! Wirtz just pulls it around the corner for Haywood, and then coming across, Aisha Norrie. And she's done so well, she's earned a side of goal kick, so it's gone out last off Haywood. What an outstanding player she is, and just embodies everything good about this Brisbane Roar side. Was part of the Lions side that won the treble in Queensland this season. Bleeds orange for this Brisbane Roar side in her 72nd match. In the Liberty A-League, that's across her time as well with Perth and Melbourne Victory. But an absolute rock in the heart of midfield for Brisbane Roar. Murray almost had it pinched by Gorey, and Gorey's come back and almost won it off Westland. Sasaki with the ball forward to Murray. There's space out to the right where Westland was, but Holmes just couldn't get it there. And now Dorber dinking and handcuff reading the situation. Handcuff, who joined Brisbane this season on loan from Gotham FC, didn't play last season in the NWSL, but is a real prospect for the US, a US national youth team player. Also spent time in her younger years training with Orlando Pride, so she's had a good season so far for Brisbane Roar. Couple of clean sheets so far in those wins against Western Sydney and Newcastle. Marushka Waldus over hits for Wirtz, and this is the problem for Adelaide. Again, these balls forward, not finding feet, not finding players in white. And it was the same story on Wednesday night against Melbourne City. It's just incredible how things can turn around so markedly from last season. And Leah Blaney and myself touched on this in the call on Wednesday night when Adelaide went down 3-0 to Melbourne City. Not a massive difference in personnel. Kayla Sharples really the only regular starter that is missing this season. She was really important defensively, but it's not there that Adelaide have had a whole lot of issues this season until lately. It's been from that attacking perspective. And that's why the free kick went the way of the Reds. And Brisbane giving away a fair few fouls in this one so far, which is surprising because Adelaide actually have given away the most across the competition thus far. Brisbane not quite that high up, but they are today. And there's another one. Just having a look at that Adelaide side that played in the finals last year against Melbourne Victory, the players that have switched from last season to this. So no Sharples, McNamara as well, and Omiya, the Japanese recruit, but that is it. Everyone else remains the same. They do have the loss, of course, a big loss of Emily Condon. Adrian Stent is trying to deal with that. She's out with a groin injury. Katie Bowler is also out with a quad complaint. And then Ella Tonkin probably out for the season with a foot injury. And you add that to Jenna McCormick, who is out with a groin injury at the moment. So there's a few key players on the sidelines. But still, they've got quality out there, Adelaide. They should be able to create more than they are in the final third. Just not happening for them at the moment. They've got 10 minutes until half time. Because it's over 6 hours now. 6 hours and about 13 minutes since they last scored. Wirtz looked to have pushed Rashard in the back, and that's a decision from Beck Mackey. Rashard has actually said she expects this to be her final season in the Liberty A-League. Wouldn't she love to help Brisbane towards the finals? They win this one right now on the live ladder with the three competition points, and they are only goal difference away from being inside the top four. Their goal difference significantly worse than Melbourne Victory. That's what they're going to have to improve if they are to really feature at the back end of the season. They can't be minus five as they are at the moment with the 1-0 lead. That needs to improve. Melbourne Victory plus five, both on 13 points as it stands. Adelaide down in sixth on 12 points with a loss calculated today on the live ladder. But there's still plenty of time to play out in this one. And Brisbane have another set piece. Good response this from Brisbane after the 4-1 loss to Sydney. India Page Riley, the goal scorer in this one. And if you missed it, yes, she signed for Brisbane as an injury replacement for Marielle Hecker this week. She's been with the Raw training for the last 3 weeks, getting acclimatised after making the move across from Fortuna Jørring in Denmark. Gorrie, neat delivery. Lind with the header. Couldn't get the placement. It didn't matter anyway because the flag has come up for offside. And Holmes's pass to no one from a Reds perspective. They almost look devoid of ideas in the final third of the pitch, Adelaide. You just get the feeling if they score one, they could go on a run because they've got players that when they're confident can really get firing, as we saw from Fiona Wirtz last season. Chelsea Dauber grabbed 10. India Page Riley for Brisbane. Rashard, neat delivery deep towards that back post. Shay Connors tracks it down. Katrina Gorrie has to try and get on a bike. She leaves it for India Page Riley. The Kiwi international rolls it out to Rashard. Gorrie has time. It's a low cross, easily dealt with by Sasaki. Gorrie will be disappointed because we know her quality of finding a pass, and she just looks a little frustrated. She couldn't put it in a better position there for Larissa Crummer, because you think Sasaki, not the tallest player on the pitch. That's a mismatch. If Waldus just leaves Crummer, Well, there's a massive opportunity, a massive advantage she's got in height to not in another goal this season. She's already got 2.26 in her A-League women's career. And Talitha Kramer, well, she just kept going. Beck Mackey's coming back for the free kick. Be interested to see if there was much going on there. At the moment, the intensity is just not there from the Reds. We know it is a hot day. We know it is their third match in a week, so they do have some intervening factors. This is Kramer taking on Dorver. Maybe a little bit of a tug. Goes at it again. Some would argue not much. Probably the Brisbane persuasion. There's Paige Haywood finding the cross. It beats everyone. Except eventually Jamila Rankin to clear away. A slight opening maybe there from Adelaide. That was a decent delivery. Barbieri. Dorber just ran into a cul-de-sac in the form of Palmer. And gives away the free kick. And that pretty much sums up the first half from Adelaide. Brisbane have dealt with everything. Dorber just gives it away. Legs Palmer. Down she goes. Free kick Brisbane. And now they get another one. So Adelaide, they've given away the most fouls in the competition this season, 97. Heading into this one, so they're almost raising the bat. 98 at the moment, they're slowly catching Brisbane in this one. Handcuff, neat skills away from Holmes. Holmes just screaming at her side, wanting more intensity, you feel, because they had Brisbane. 10 down there in the corner. And now Fiona Wirtz just gets in behind momentarily. Murray just couldn't get on the end of the pass, and to be fair, it was a long way ahead of her. And now Grove into Crummer, who's going to track this down. I don't know if that would go down as a big chance for Adelaide, but they've created the second most big chances this season, but they've got the worst conversion rate in the competition, 20%. Does this go down as a big chance? You'd have to ask the Boffins. I don't think so. Was a little bit too far in front of Amelia Murray, but a half chance. Wirtz gets that cross a little further back, and Murray's got a one-on-one there with Handcuff. More headaches from an injury perspective, though, for the Reds and Adrian Stenter. And this is the usual captain, Hodgson. Hopefully, it's just a cork. Maybe a knee in the quad there. Chelsea Dorber, the captain for today. And the reason she's got the armband, it was her 50th match on Wednesday. You can see the thumbs up from the physio, so Hodgson should be all good to go. But yeah, Chelsea Dorber, 23rd birthday this week. 50th match on Wednesday. And Larissa Crummer, she's getting up there towards the century of matches in this competition. 95th appearance. Second most experienced raw player out there behind Katrina Gorry. A Penny for his thoughts. He has not been in this kind of situation in the Liberty A-League, Adrian Stenter. Three straight losses. What is he going to talk about at halftime? He's such an impressive coach when you hear him speak. And Katrina, well, that's a great strike off the post from Katrina Gorey. And that's what she can do just out of nowhere. And now Connors, the deflection is going to ensure another corner here for Brisbane. They're really pushing it in on Adelaide right before half time. Penning them inside their own defensive third. And Katrina Gorey was that close to making it two for the Roar. Fighting towards the near post. Fell for Connors. Well, Beck Mackey says get up. She was asking for potentially a penalty as she was clipped by Murray. Not enough for a penalty according to Beck Mackey. They cannot afford to concede a second. Rashard. Palmer. And they find one more chance before half time. Just over a minute remaining in stoppage time. Connors off the chest of Crummer. Hasn't got a whole lot of great service in this first half, Larissa Crummer. And Hayward just trying to knock it up and chase, but nothing doing for Adelaide. On his 40th birthday, Gareth McPherson looking to celebrate with 3 points. It's looking pretty good as we near half time. India Paige Riley's goal, the difference at this point. She's found the back of the net twice in this match. First time ruled out for offside. Second, a fantastic strike. Sasaki's delivery finds Wirtz. Maybe the last kick of this first half or the last opportunity. Wirtz looking for the free kick. Wasn't forthcoming. Haywood. Is there a delivery here at the end of it for Adelaide? Wirtz working it out with Haywood. And Katrina Gorey has done expertly well, as you would expect from a former AFC Player of the Year. So much quality. She won't be able to track that down. And that will do us for the opening 45 minutes in Brisbane. And Brisbane Roar, thanks to India Paige Riley's strike, lead Adelaide United at halftime at AJ Kelly Park by a goal to nil. And the first half stats tell you limited opportunities, but Brisbane have been more clinical. Adelaide's chances, well, they've been half chances at best. And the most important part of this match for Brisbane, well, it hasn't been beautiful football. It's the goal. It's the 1-0 advantage. It's the 3 points they have at the moment as it stands that would push them towards the top four. So we're going to take a quick break. We'll be back for the second half in about 15 minutes from AJ Kelly Park. Welcome back to Redcliffe. This is match day 10 of the Liberty A-League, and it's Brisbane Roar leading Adelaide United by a goal to nil, and it's their new recruit, India Paige Riley, back in orange for the first time since 2020. And it was Talitha Kramer's good work. Adelaide couldn't clear, and Riley thumped it into the back of the net. The New Zealand international has signed for the Roar because she wanted more game time in the lead up to the World Cup. She's in the New Zealand squad. After playing the one match for the Matildas, she switched allegiance, and what an opportunity for her it is later this season with that World Cup at home, and obviously into fantastic form after returning from Denmark, where she was playing for Fortuna Hjørring. And the crowd keeping themselves entertained at halftime. Maybe some posting on social media going on at AJ Kelly Park. And Brisbane Roar, of course, looking to bounce back from that defeat to Sydney on New Year's Eve. Their first match in a couple of weeks, so they are fresh, ready to go. And they've got 45 minutes ahead of them, which could be pretty significant for their season, because they do have a game in hand on a few sides, because this is only their eighth match of the season. So they're not quite at the halfway point of 18 matches. And that's a real opportunity for them to push on and put those top four sides under pressure. Currently, they're only goal difference away from the top four if you look at the ladder. But it is quite significant. So here we go, second half underway. Brisbane Roar looking to bounce back, of course, from that most recent match against Adelaide United, that 8-2 loss. And they are going along nicely at the moment against a red side who just need to score and need to end a three-match losing run. So Nano Sasaki, sometimes it's set pieces where you can jag a goal and get things flowing, but that delivery, well, it wasn't fantastic. Gorry missed it, fell for Walders, appeals for handball, and it's a penalty for Adelaide United. So just something out of nothing. Walders just had a snap on goal. It was an aimless free kick, to be fair. And almost a comedy of errors, and it may have been Talitha Kramer who did so well to set up Brisbane's first goal. And now Chelsea Dorber, Adelaide's all-time leading goal scorer, with a chance to end a more than 6-hour goal drought. And she's just going to build the suspense a little more. Just having some issues with the penalty spot here. And you can see Adelaide have made a change at halftime. Sasha Khoury there on. The youngster watching on as Chelsea Dorber looks to score. And the goal drought is ended from the penalty spot. Chelsea Dorber with the equaliser, her 20th Liberty A-League goal. And of course, it was the Reds' all-time goal scorer, the record holder, who drove the ball past handcuff and ended the more than 6-hour wait for a goal for Adelaide United fans. The captain for today as well, after reaching 50 Liberty A-League matches on Wednesday night. So how does this impact the Reds? Just a bit of luck goes their way. They haven't had a whole lot of it in recent matches. It's a brilliant penalty though, isn't it, from Dorber. Nailed into the bottom corner. One all. in Redcliffe, and you can just see confirmation of that change. Sasha Khoury on for Mindy Barbieri at halftime. Maybe another chance on the way for Dauber. You just had that feeling that once Adelaide ended the goal drought, they may have a chance to go on and score more with the confidence flowing. And you just wonder whether that gets the creative juices flowing for Chelsea Dauber and the Reds. Brisbane, they've got to put that behind them. Holly Palmer driving forward, shooting from range, won't trouble Annie Grove. Wirtz putting some pressure on Rashart now. So the intensity off the back of the goal for Adelaide has just gone up from a level which was probably disappointing if you're Adrian Stenter in the first half. Space found by India Paige Riley. She's going for goal again. Annie Grove has to push it around the corner. Isn't she full of confidence? The new recruit, she is proving very valuable. Marielle Hecker's replacement. They lost Hecker, of course, in December to the ACL injury. Bring in India Paige Riley. Really good signing for Gareth McPherson's team. Good bunch of Queenslanders in this Raw side. Youngsters and experienced like Gorry, her delivery solid. And now Holly Palmer, Crummer, tried to have a strike, it just spins in the air. Awkward to deal with, awkward for Gorry. She shouldn't be wasted on throws, and that is the decision from Brisbane to leave it for Kramer. Crummer with Gorry. Crummer will want to get in the box to try and take advantage of Gorry's delivery, but Adelaide got numbers across. Norrie, passing lane shut down by Dauber, who feeds Amelia Murray. Taking on Rankin, two talented youngsters going shoulder to shoulder here. Rankin versus Murray, and Rankin's one out. A bit more experience for the 19-year-old Jamila Rankin, still a teenager as well. In her 35th Liberty A-League match, Shea Connors, meanwhile, delivering, and if it wasn't for Waldus, well, they may score anyway. It's just gonna be a goal kick. India Paige Riley has got the roar on her back, and she is doing everything in her power to try and get them back in front. Some of the home fans thought she had scored as the back of the net bulged. For a moment, it looked as though they had grabbed themselves a second, just flashed wide. What a sweet strike it was. And this match providing plenty of entertainment at the start of the second half. We saw a really energetic opening from both sides. The first 10 minutes was frantic, chances at both ends, and then a little duller for the remainder of the first half. And the second half, it started in a similar vein. Amelia Murray, space aplenty, feeds it off to Sasha Khoury, and what a save from Handcuff to deny the 17-year-old. Sasaki sizing up whether to shoot. Dorver has space. Dorver will clip it towards the back post. And what a talent Sasha Khoury, as we saw her make her A-League women's debut off the bench on Wednesday against Melbourne City. And she almost grabbed a goal in just her second appearance in the competition. Brisbane just trying to slow things down here after the temperature has risen at the start of this second half. Handcuffs clearance, somewhat a scuffed attempt, but Katrina Gorry used her body beautifully there to earn the whistle and a free kick. Again, brilliantly done by Katrina Gorry, looking to link up with India Paige Riley. You feel those two as they get this combination flowing over the coming weeks. It's only going to be more and more dangerous. Gorry again using Riley. Haywood gets across to smother her path to goal. It looks as though Gareth McPherson's going to go to his bench as well after Sasha Khoury came on for Adelaide at halftime for Mindy Barbieri. Still, they're going to wait Brisbane to make this change. Happy to let play go on. Shea Connors dispossessed by Dorber and has dropped back to do some defensive work. The goal scorer for Adelaide, who ended a more than 6 hour run without a goal. Wayward pass. So Tamar Levin about to make her way onto AJ Kelly Park. And maybe coming on for India Paige Riley, which would be a huge loss for Brisbane, but obviously getting up her match minutes, her first appearance in her second stint at Brisbane Roar. Scored the goal in the first half, had one in the back of the net as well, and then in the second half came close on a couple of occasions. That goal in the first half, as well as the goal disallowed for offside. She has been in everything for Brisbane Roar. Good strength from the substitute. Annie Grove out to find Haywood. Dauber unable to keep it from crossing the sideline. So big half an hour coming up for both sides, but especially Adelaide on the back of their third match in a week. Big push of energy required here from Adrian Stenter's team as they look to end this three-match losing run. Gorey, so good with the ball at her feet. Palmer now finding Rashart. Levin driving it in. Comfortable for Annie Grove. Ayesha Norrie, just too much intensity, too much energy from the Brisbane Roar captain, and she just couldn't finish it off. And they are just looking a little leggy here, Adelaide United, and you can understand why. After a big week of football and travel, and Norrie almost able to take advantage. Katrina Gorey trying to slide between Holmes and also Haywood. Rashart, good distribution from the throw, straight to Crummer. He's able to hold it up, but couldn't earn a corner. The next best thing, though, earning a throw. Rashart again looking for Crummer. And on the volley, it's forced a great save out of Anna Lee Grove. Another chance for Brisbane in this second half. Hodgson. Good link up. Things starting to flow down that right channel. Chelsea Dauber dropping in and finding the pass. It'll only take one moment for the Reds. On fatiguing legs, this would be a massive win for them. If they're able to turn it around in the final 28 minutes or so. But they're trying to soak up a lot of pressure being applied here by Brisbane Roar. Nano Sasaki in that centre back role, doing a terrific job. Shay Connors driving in low. Sasaki didn't know much about it. He's conceding a corner. Well, it was from the set piece that Adelaide won the penalty. In the second half, maybe Brisbane can get one back here from the corner. It's deep from Palmer. And Dorber, plenty of touches, plenty of involvement from the Adelaide captain in this second half. As Amelia Murray, neat ball forward towards Westland. But Norrie dropping back from midfield to sweep and clean up for Brisbane. Shay Connors just offside. You could just see again, Shay Connors just straying offside. Sasaki, Murray, Sasha Khoury, good ball wide to Dorber. Can she find the delivery? It was into a dangerous area. She's won it back again, Dorber. Finds Murray, who couldn't pick out the top corner from a tight angle. Was always going to be hard to beat handcuffed going to the near post, but she was almost able to squeeze it in that top corner. The 18-year-old looking for her second goal of the season. Handcuffed, put under some real pressure by Amelia Murray. Gorrie clipping it to Levin. Rashard against the sideline. And here's this chance a moment ago for Adelaide. Amelia Murray just wondered maybe handcuff had it covered. But it was another good opportunity for Adelaide in this second half. I believe that's gone the way of Crummer. Potentially for something she said after the free kick was given. So joining Lind in the book for Brisbane Roar. Larissa Crummer feeding Levin, and Tamar Levin with the strike. It deflected into the path of Palmer. Norrie, now Kramer. Good turn that from Shay Connors. Still going Connors, blocked off her angle. She'll get another bite at the cherry. Connors with the deflection earns a set piece in the form of a corner. Still chasing her first goal of the season. Seven last campaign for Shay. Nano Sasaki just doing enough to push that strike from Connors wide. And just confirmation of that yellow card for Larissa Crummer a moment ago. So Lind in the book, the centre half for Brisbane, and Crummer as well. The two cards from this one. Set piece driven into a good area, and Annalie Grove, fortunate. It was straight at her because it should have. Probably asked more questions of the Adelaide goalkeeper. And it was Lind. She'll be so disappointed she didn't put it to either side of the Adelaide keeper. So there's the chance for Brisbane. Off the back of that golden one Adelaide had a few moments ago for Amelia Murray. Curry allowed to go on. Beck Mackey playing on for the Reds here. Dauber opens up the angle but couldn't wait the pass for Curry. Sasha Curry, a product of the Football South Australia NTC. He's been involved in Junior Matilda's camps and also signed that scholarship deal at the start of the season with the Reds. As Isabel Hodgson replaced by Emily Hodgson, so a like-for-like switch there. Isabel Hodgson, the usual captain for the Reds, or the club captain, but not today with Chelsea Dauber getting the armband off the back of that 50th appearance on a Wednesday. And both sides, it is hot in Brisbane today, mid to high 20s in Kippering in Redcliffe, or just near Redcliffe. So both sides taking the opportunity to have a quick squirt of water as we see Chelsea Dauber. What a finish that was. Under pressure as well, because they're down 1-0. They haven't scored in over 6 hours of football. And she goes and pops it away in the bottom corner. And good to see her back on the score sheet. 20th goal in the Liberty A-League in her 51st appearance. Who's come back on loan from the Chicago Red Stars, where she's playing in the NWSL. Just the 4 appearances for her last season, 85 minutes. So really important she gets a solid season of the A-League women under her belt. And look at this, Adelaide, who have played 3 matches in a week, are saying, come on, let's go. Brisbane, they haven't played in 2 weeks. They want a bit more time to have a rest. And Gareth McPherson, and they said, we're going to make a change. I tell you what, for all the teams in the competition, if you looked at the draw at the start of the season, you'd be pretty happy with how it panned out for Brisbane. They last played on New Year's Eve. They could have a bit of a celebration, knowing that they didn't have to play again for a couple of weeks, and fresh and ready for this one. So Sian Fryer comes on, replacing Jesse Rashard. Fryer, who started the last match but dropped to the bench today in favour of the new signing, India Paige Riley. Gorey again, backing into the challenge, looking to win the ball. Couldn't scrap it her way. Amelia Murray just slipped at the key moment. Rankin's touch was heavy. Allowed Wirtz to pounce. Westland stubs it through well. Frustration for Adelaide because they could have played advantage. Beck Mackey opting to hand the yellow ticket out, but the Adelaide bench will be frustrated that there was no advantage played there because there was space down the right. Here it was, Westland into the path of Murray. Brisbane were scrambling. Kramer yellow carded. And it's Sasaki over the dead ball. Just had to crane the neck muscles a little too much to Paige Haywood. Brisbane have been giving away a few fouls today. There's another one to add to the count. Curry got the head to it. No white shirt rushing through. So inside the final 20 minutes of regulation time. Can one of these two sides grab a winner? It's been a while since Adelaide actually recorded a draw in the Liberty A-League, more than 3 years. Usually it's 3 points or nothing for the Reds. Maybe today they could grab a point. You can hear the frustration coming from both benches as this free kick was awarded to Brisbane. Shoulder to shoulder, Haywood and Gorrie. Didn't look like a whole lot in that. Good pressure from Khoury. Really good pressure from the 17-year-old, but Hensley handcuffed and read the situation well. She wasn't to know that the flag was going to come up. Samar Levin had the attempted cross blocked by Hodgson, and Emily Hodgson is off, linking neatly with Fiona Wirtz. And well, it's a tough decision for the throw. That's a really difficult decision for the referee and assistant. Does go the way of Brisbane, but Dylan Holmes looks up, sees Amelia Murray, lovely ball slipped in behind, and then Jamila Rankin came across to stop the Adelaide striker. Now Lind is slow to get to her feet. It's fallen awkwardly. Doesn't look like there's anything sinister at this point. Amelia Murray, she's been busy today. Got herself about, had some chances. And Linda's going to walk towards the sideline. It's a good tackle coming across. Rankin covering for a centre back partner. Final 15 minutes here in Redcliffe, and the cross from Crummer just had a little too much weight on it. Again, I think some of the Brisbane fans thought it was a goal as it flashed over onto the roof of the net. Haywood picked off again by Brisbane. Gorrie. And here's Emily Hodgson, fresh legs off the bench, linking with Wirtz. And now Westland. Well, that's more like it from Adelaide. Amelia Murray. And that was good, quick ball movement from the Reds. It hasn't happened too often today, but when it did, they look really dangerous. And this is the chance moments ago for Larissa Crummer. Well, probably not a chance, just a miss hit cross. Lind back to handcuff, and Adrian Center, he's got to like what he saw there, and they move the ball quickly in transition. They really ask some questions of Brisbane, but those moments have been few and far between today. Shay Connors, dispossessed by Emily Hodgson. Connors charging after it. Waldis and Grove. Good distribution out to Dorber. And Dorber looks heavily fatigued here. Warm conditions again for Adelaide to deal with. Remember on Wednesday they were playing the game at home in temperatures that were nearing 30 or just under. And again, just 3 days between games. Up to Brisbane, they had the travel. Temperature up in the similar range. So it's been a really rough week for the Reds, as we've touched on already. So this is a massive 11 minutes for them. And they've got a break of a week until that next match against Melbourne. Victory at home. And that one is a critical contest when it comes to the race for the top four, because Victory just sitting on the edge of the four. And for Brisbane, they'd love 3 points here, because they would go level with Victory on 13 points with a win. Hodgson spills for Wirtz. Good turn from Fiona Wirtz. And now Sasha Khoury has it pinched off her by, guess who? You know who it is. It's Katrina Gorrie. And she's releasing Shay Connors. And now Larissa Crummer onside. No, she's not. Frustration evident from the Raw striker. And it all came from Katrina Gorrie. How about that? The 17-year-old has it taken off her by the Matildas, veteran of so much experience. 88 caps for the national team. Also spent some time at the Reds as well. Just the one season for Katrina Gorrie. One goal in that 10-11 season across her 9 appearances. Sasaki. Both technically good players, her and Gorrie, but Gorrie with the desperation and desire won out, but then Holmes won it back for Adelaide. Beck Mackey's going to play advantage for Adelaide here. And what a chance for Dorber. She broke it past Hensley Handcuff, but the flag comes up again. It's been a game of offsides, this one. And Dorber, her shot had too much power for Handcuff. And Adrian Stenter asking for the yellow card for the hold, but that's the rule when you play advantage. A strange one it is in that kind of situation, as Gorrie, she's done it before. Proved to be the match winner for Brisbane Roar. And she's still got a chance to put her imprint on this match. Or you could say even more of an imprint than she already has. Thank you. Haywood. Westland. Wirtz had the angles closed down by Rankin, just out-muscled her on that occasion. And Tamar Levin uses her goalkeeper. Waldis left it behind. Handcuffed, put under real pressure by Wirtz, and now Dorber looking to profit. Kramer uses all her experience there to earn the whistle of Beck Mackey. Just convinced the referee there was enough. Jeez, there was not much at all. So the Adelaide match winner, maybe, Zhao Yuyi, the Chinese international, a match winner for China in the Asian Cup last year, the winner in stoppage time to claim them the crown, 3-2 over South Korea. You could say a red letter day that for Chinese football. Well, she's playing for the Reds. Could she do it again here? It would be worth so much to Adelaide. And allowed to go on, Fiona Wirtz. Khoury. A lot of players over this right-hand side of the field for the Reds. All the space was out to the left. There was no one stationed out there. Holmes has been strong in midfield again, Dylan Holmes, trying to will her side on, the former Adelaide captain, Sasaki. Distribution just off there, over the top of Khoury. Gorey to Connors. Shay Connors, dazzling footwork. The finish evades her. Adrian Stenter breathes a sigh of relief. Meanwhile, at the other end, Adelaide charging forward with Wirtz, and the header almost had hearts in mouths. Can Adelaide pinch one late here? Significant win this would be to turn the tide of their season. Wirtz, can she put it on a dime for Walder? Spills for Holmes. What's the decision here from Beck Mackey? She says, let's go to the other corner. Nervy moments for the home side. And to this point, it's not a match you really thought they were going to lose. They led 1-0, had chances. The penalty just after halftime. Now Adelaide with a chance. It's a great corner from Wirtz. Handcuff has to push it away. Holly Palmer drives it up the line. And now Zhao Yuyi. Haywood, Sasaki, steps away from the press and the pressure. The ball's coming back with interest, and Gareth McPherson, you can see his head bend back with frustration as that free kick was given for the contact on Dorber. Ishinori questioning the decision of Beck Mackey. Brisbane under the pump here, the home team soaking up all the pressure late on. Nano Sasaki looking to put this into a dangerous area once again. Handcuff is rising. She only got a fist to it. Fry got it away initially with the header, and then Levin was able to clear it up over halfway. It's the home side looking to batten down the hatches here late. Maybe they can spring forward as Levin won it back for the roar. Gorry, there's one player you'd want to have the ball at her feet. From a Brisbane perspective, she's given it up. And from an Adelaide perspective, you'd say Chelsea Dauber. She's got herself involved heavily in this second half. Haywood has Dauber on the inside, didn't use her. Opted for the more risky pass to Fiona Wirtz. Sasaki will track it down. The halfway point of this 2022-23 Liberty A-League season. And there's so much riding on this one. Two teams separated by just a couple of points. And we've got five additional minutes. Five more minutes of drama here in Kippering. Crummer, maybe in two minds, kicks at the turf in frustration. Just a little unsure whether to shoot or cross. And she didn't either in the end, just laid it into the lap of Grove. It's been the issue for Brisbane this season is they've been solid defensively, they've been solid from a goal scoring sense, middle of the range across the league. They just improve slightly in both areas and they could push themselves up the table. Home fans trying to urge them on here with the throw. Fryer, good energy from Dauber. Back into the mix. Grove with a chance to release here, quickly for Adelaide. Hodgson. Wirtz. The door's just closing on her. Murray, good intensity from Amelia Murray. It's earned Adelaide possession. Wirtz, and now Murray, and just couldn't keep her shot down. And the legs no doubt filled with lactic acid at this point in time. Great effort from Murray to initially earn Adelaide possession, but couldn't make herself a match winner. Maybe yet. You sense there's still another opportunity for either side. Gorry. Rushing away, Katrina Gorry. She shoots. But it's comfortable for Grove. She had three reds in front of her trying to block that angle to goal. And this is a good release from Grove towards Dauber. They're under pressure. Fiona Wirtz unleashed. What a moment that would have been to open her account for the season. It's end-to-end stuff here. Shay Connors around the corner for Gorry, and that's deflected, so it should be a corner. 2 minutes remaining. An intriguing conclusion in Redcliffe as Brisbane look to snatch 3 points late. It's been such an even affair. Jamila Rankin on the left towards Crummer, falls for Gorey. And it will just be a goal kick as much as Brisbane wanted the corner. Ayesha Norrie is going to go into the book for what she's had to say there to Beck Mackey. So there may be a little bit more time added on as Chelsea Dorber makes her way to the sideline. What an effort she put in today. Zoe Tolland with her third appearance in the Liberty A-League. Just confirmation there, Ayesha Norrie into the referee's book. Free kick now for Brisbane. Maybe it's they who will have the final chance of this match. Holly Palmer. It could be all on this for Brisbane Roar. Adelaide desperate to hold them out as they look to end this three-match losing run. And Palmer is floating. It falls for Gorey. Well blocked off by the Reds, and Emily Hodgson is off. Norrie gives away the free kick. She has to be careful. She doesn't want to go into the book again for back chat. And we may still have some seconds because of the booking. So could Adelaide create one final chance? Hodgson. Curry is after it. What a win from Sasha Curry. She drives it towards goal. And it's wide. And that probably will be it. What an entertaining finish to this match in Queensland. So it's a point apiece after a pulsating finish to this Liberty A-League clash. The losing run is over for the Reds. Chelsea Dorver's second half penalty cancelling out India Paige Riley's opener for Brisbane on her return to the A-League Women's. Would you believe it's the Reds' first draw in the Liberty A-League in more than 3 years, but they will take it. They stay in fifth position, just outside the top four. Brisbane not too far back on the ladder as it finishes 1-1 in Kipper Ring. Let's have a look at the match stats from AJ Kelly Park. And as you can see, Brisbane Roar dominating the shots. And late on, they were firing a lot at Adelaide. But the Reds had their opportunities as well in the second half. In the end, neither side was able to find a match winner at AJ Kelly Park. And at the halfway point of the season, it's a result which both coaches will probably take at this point in time. As just having a look at what this means for the ladder at this point in time in the Liberty A-League. So Adelaide stay fifth on 13 points, Brisbane seventh on 11 points with their second draw of the season. Thanks for your company from AJ Kelly Park this afternoon. It finished Brisbane Roar 1, Adelaide United 1.
Yeah, we look nice, future looking nice, we don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Yeah, we look nice, future looking real nice, we don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.